for an N10 title.
Absolutely. Wofford comes in 8-1 overall, undefeated in N10 play. Cyrus 7-2.
It gives these seniors a lot of confidence that, yeah, you know we can play with this other team.
Absolutely.
We did it a year ago. Let's see if we can do it again. Receivers on each side. Murdoch gets the handoff or gets the snap, and then as he decides to run with it, he was having a hard time getting his footing. Probably picked up about a yard or so where he's going to have to put this one up in the air.
Oh.
And it's over his head.
Oh, no.
All the way down to the 3-yard line. He's going to have to just try to fall on top of it, and he did. He probably had a little room to pick it up, but didn't want to take his chances, and he's just going to go right behind the center, up and over, and he's in.
Yes.
6 points quickly for the Wofford Royals on one play. Again, Keaton Tyner just following his center. That one is up, and it looks pretty good, and it is. 10:23 on the clock here in the first quarter. Wofford Royals strike first. Shotgun formation. Murdoch gets the ball. He'll try to go handoff, and that running back's going to be taken down immediately. Going to be a loss of yardage on their first play of the game. And just moving down, they'll fake the handoff to Williams, throw it over to the left side. It's Schluter who picked up the catch. He's going to be met right away. Nick Looker picked him up. And,
I think he actually might have lost the yard.
Yeah. Go quick pass. Oh,
oh, he got picked off.
Unbelievable catch right there. Defensive lineman Hayden Rhodes, who is playing defensive end. They have the shotgun formation of Tyner. He's going to pass the ball. He got his receiver, Wilburn, who got open. And Wilburn probably ends up falling forward for the first down.
Yeah, I think he did get it.
Murdoch going to look right. He's looking that way. He looks for his third receiver. He's getting some pressure from behind. He'll end up throwing it down the field. He kind of just threw it away. And it's going to bring up a second down and 10. No receivers open down the field. So it's going to bring up a third down and probably 10 here for the Redmen. I don't even think they got a yard on that play. They will line up.
It's going to
be a fake. It's going to be Looker coming on the side. He's got it. He's definitely going to pick up the first down there. The Bucyrus Redmen just completely overlooking. The last play, they seemed like they were looking for it a little bit. He's going to go back. He's looking left side with it. He's going to throw the ball. He's got receiver.
Oh,
and he's got him.
I don't think that's the one he was throwing to.
No, I don't know that he was either. He's just going to take it and run once again. Winford's there to meet him, though. And I don't think got it there, that's for sure.
Nice job by the Wofford defense.
Fight their way in, push it in.
Oh, he got caught in the backfield. Nice job.
Outstanding play by Kyle Skidmore.
Wow.
With Williams in the backfield. He's going to roll to the right. He's looking into the end zone. He doesn't see anything.
No room.
And he had no place to try to go there. He ends up going out of bounds at the 6, so he lost a little bit more yards. Again, bring everybody in tight. They'll hand it off. They got a hole right there.
Uh-oh.
Going up the middle is Looker. He's going to get somebody from behind.
Yeah,
going to drag him down, but that's going to be a big first down run to him. And
he's
got a hole.
Free.
He ends up coming up. Murdoch has to come up and make the tackle. Ball came out late, but they're going to say he's down. Okay.
Yeah.
Again, pistol formation this time. They'll give it to Hayden Rhodes, his first carry of the game.
Man.
And you see the power running right there of Hayden Rhodes. They're going to go Tyner behind Rhodes' lead blocker. He's got a little bit of room where he's going to be met at about 8 yards downfield or so. That's where Bucyrus will corral him. He's got Rhodes with him in the backfield. This time he's going to throw. He's going to go over the middle looking for Wilburn. He's got
him.
Got behind the defender, and they'll make the tackle inside the 5-yard line. But a big pickup right there. Behind Tyner, they'll give it to Looker. He's just going to power forward, and he got it.
They got him that time.
He got a good push in front of him that time. And Nick Looker has his first carry of the game, or first touchdown of the game, excuse me. He's clapping with Richardson in the backfield with him. He's got some pressure.
Oh,
he's
in the end zone.
They got
safety.
Him. They got him for the safety. And there is, I think, Skidmore, who was the one who got back
there. Yes, they marked
the
safety.
They're going to come right side with it. It's Tyner. He gets a good block to get around the corner. He's down to the 30 and inside there, probably 27-yard line before he's brought down. So it's going to be a first down there on the first down run. They're going to end up running left side that with Tyner. He's got some room on the outside. He's going to cut inside. They're about the 10-yard line. He's going to give it just shy of the 10, where they'll mark him down another first down. This time they'll go under center, turn around, and hand it off to Rhodes. He's going to power forward, get inside the 5. And it's actually one of the defensive backs, Hollis, who stepped up and just kind of tripped him up from getting into the end zone. But this time, ball's down. He barely got it down, but Shuttler did an outstanding job picking it up and putting it down, and he got it. So big field goal right there by Jalen Brown. But there's just not a lot there for Cole Murdoch.
No.
So probably don't think he got a yard on that play. Maybe he got one. Tyner under center. He's going to turn around, just hand it off. It's going to be Looker just power running, and he gets a pretty good run. 7:45 and counting on the clock. Snap does come back. He's going to take a couple steps and kick it and go straight up in the air.
Sire's
going to watch out, and then it's going to be down at the 14-yard line. I don't know.
The guy just picked it up and was trying to run it.
I don't understand that. You have to blow the whistle there. Some of the refs are just standing around looking at each
other.
What is going on here?
You've got to blow the whistle because the clock is still running.
What are you doing here? I mean, that ends up being a very short punt. What is going on here?
Yes, they did. Oh, my.
They're saying they touched the ball, and Winford picked it up. He caught it in the air and started running with it. They've got Rhodes in the backfield. He's going to be the one getting the handoff. He goes right side. He's got an opening.
He makes
the guy break. And it's only his fourth carry of the game, but it ends up being a killer right there, 36-yard pickup. This one's more of a pistol formation. They're going to fake the handoff to Rhodes. He's going to go right side. Tyner, as he's got room. He's open. He's down to the 10 to the 5, and he's going to scamper into the end zone untouched. 20-yard run for the Winford Royals, and that will certainly put an end to this ball game. Everybody's moving around. They're going to throw a quick screen pass over to Williams.
Oh, nice
and
play down
Winford
there.
Winford is right there on it. Nice job, Braxton T. right there.
Yeah.
For the Royals. It's going to be Hoffman who takes the snap. He's going to get a first down on the outside. He's going to go way into Bucyrus territory.
He's gone.
He's going to put in another touchdown on the board. Zach Hoffman, the backup quarterback, just piled in the game and runs for a 56-yard touchdown run for the Winford Royals. Just a little insult to injury. Again, I think for Bucyrus, they were kind of looking at it like, you know, they didn't push real hard into the backfield, and they will hold on to the copper kettle for the 17th straight year. Another great win. I'll be honest with you, it was a really close game in halftime.
It was. We're looking at 7-0, and we're talking about somebody's going to have to make a big play.
Yeah.
Wow. All of a sudden, Winford just wore Bucyrus down.
Yeah, they sure did. Yeah.